Hello, and welcome to episode 2 of my First Reef Aquarium. In the previous episode, we explained how a reef system works. In this episode, we will list the equipment you need for the job and the key takeaway for each piece of equipment. So, without further ado, let's get started. 1. The aquarium. The aquarium glass should be ultra clear, so you can fully enjoy the vivid colors of your fish and corals. The aquarium itself must be reef ready, which means that it comes with a sump that is located either in the lower cabinet or in the back of the aquarium, thereby keeping the gear hidden from view and enabling the level of filtration required to maintain a saltwater ecosystem. In addition, a reef-ready aquarium should filter water from the aquarium's surface in order to efficiently remove floating particles and increase oxygen level. 2. A REEF-SPEC cabinet. Any cabinet you use to support your aquarium must be able to support your system's weight. It must also be made of marine-spec materials that can withstand harsh marine conditions. And no less importantly, it should be pretty. After all, what's the point of creating a stunning reef that will magnetize anyone who sees it if it sits on a shabby-looking piece of furniture? 3. Return pump. The return pump in a reef system should be able to circulate the entire water volume approximately 10 times an hour, which is optimal for effective filtration and circulation. The mechanics of this are simple. Water from the tank flows into the sump, passes through the filters, and the return pump then pushes it back to the display tank. 4. A mechanical filter. Most hobbyists use simple solutions, such as filter socks or filter sponges. These are effective enough. However, it's very important to add a protein skimmer, which removes truly tiny waste particles out of your system before it becomes toxic. Protein skimmers must have an air-to-water intake that is sufficient to handle your system's bioload. The more fish and corals you have, the more organic waste they produce, which requires more skimming. For more detailed info on protein skimmers, check out the link in the description below. 5. A chemical filter. There are many types of chemical filters, but the most common and recommended one is activated carbon, which adsorbs color pigments and scent molecules out of the water, leaving them crystal clear. If you want to learn more, see the link below. 6. The lighting. There are several lighting options for reef tanks. Metal halides, LEDs, and fluorescent D5s. Most hobbyists choose LEDs, which are the most energy efficient and easy to work with. In the previous episode, we said that the key criteria for a reef light is configuration to the blue and violet spectrum and sufficient power. But here are two more practical points. The light should allow us to set automated day and night light cycles so the corals are not overexposed, and it should be able to be easily positioned at the right height, whether with a mounting arm or a pendant. We have a great lighting insight series if you want to learn more. Now, if you start out with the Max Nano Peninsula, it will already include everything we've talked about so far. But whether you go with an all-in-one system or configure it by yourself, choose recognizable brands, and always read the user reviews. It's better to go with secondhand gear in good shape from a respectable manufacturer than a brand new piece of equipment which you know little about. Alright, let's continue with our essentials list. 7. Substrate. Substrate functions as a biological filter. It houses useful bacteria that break down harmful elements and speeds up the water maturation process. Substrate should be made of mostly aragonite, with a grain size of about 1 to 2 millimeters. Any smaller could result in unwanted sandstorms, while larger grains could result in trapped waste particles. 8. Live rocks. Live rocks are also vital biological filters. They can come from a natural reef, complete with useful bacteria, or they can be artificial rocks, in which case they come without the useful bacteria. The important thing is that they have plenty of nooks and crannies where the useful bacteria can develop and thrive. 9. Salt. Since the key word in reef tanks is stability, it's important to use a reliable reef salt brand that maintains consistent levels of chemical elements in each and every bucket. If you want to learn more about premium reef salts, see the description below. 10. refractometer. To test our seawater's salinity, we use a refractometer, which is a device that measures the salinity in water. Many refractometers are not actually calibrated for seawater and test brine levels instead. So we need to buy one calibrated for seawater, which allows us to accurately adjust it for reef tanks. 11. Thermostat. As we mentioned in the previous episode, the temperature in a reef aquarium should be a stable 25 to 26 degrees Celsius or 77 to 79 Fahrenheit. To keep it steady year-round, you may need to get either a heater or a chiller, depending on where you live. There are numerous good brands of both heaters and chillers, so your key considerations should be durability and energy efficiency. And that concludes our essential shopping list. Now the fun begins. We go back in time and follow how we set up this tank step by step. So check out our next episode.